Hello everyone, in today's tutorial, I'll teach you how to make these simple teleporters you see on screen. They'll take no longer than 5 minutes to set up, and so let's get right into making them. Start off by inserting a part into your world. Now we can resize this part to be precisely whatever you'd like. I'm going to go with a nice 4 by 1.5, like this, by 4, and that'll give me this nice shape. Next, I'm going to go rename this part to teleport 1. This is going to be our first teleport pad. And inside of here, I'm going to change the material to neon and the color to be a nice red color, like that. You can customize this however you like. Now, inside of this part, inside the properties menu of this part, click this add attribute. Let's call this teleport position, teleport pause. And then inside of the type down at the bottom, we're going to have this as a C frame. Just like that. And we can press save. Now we have this new attribute inside the part. Let's not worry about the attribute right now. We'll use it later. Alright. So we can click on the part and press on this plus button. And now we can add a script. Let's rename this to teleport script. Oops, I spelled that wrong. There we go. Teleport script. And inside of here, let's go ahead and get the attribute. So local telepause is going to be equal to script dot parent colon get attribute. And then the attribute that we're getting is our teleport pause. And pause is short for position. Anyways, let's drop a few lines. You can drop as many lines as you want. It really doesn't matter. And let's go script dot parent dot touched. So we are checking if the part is touched, then we're going to go colon connect function, and we're going to get hit. Hit is going to be what hit the player. And if we press enter, it should automatically add an end. Let's go local humanoid is going to be equal to hit dot parent colon find first child. And what we're trying to find is humanoid root part. Alright, I'm going to drop a few lines, and then if it's a humanoid, then what we're going to do is we are going to get our humanoid .cframe. As you can see, cframe is not automatically popping up, since the game actually doesn't know what humanoid is going to be yet. Right? So it's going to be equal to telepause, just like that. And now, going back into your main tab, don't close out of that script yet, or actually we can close that script technically, but choose a location where you want your player to teleport to. I'm going to make my player teleport over here. So what you're going to want to do is go into its C-frame, open this menu where it should say C-frame, open that up, and where it says position, copy that. We can now delete this, click on our teleport 1, and inside of our teleport pause, which is our attribute, where it's position, paste that in. And now instead of having a bunch of decimals, you can delete those. Unless you want your position to be super precise, then don't delete those. We can now deselect that, and our teleporter should work. So let's give it a go and test it out. Alright, here I am in the game. If we step on the pad, we get teleported away. Now if you want to go back to that position, just repeat the process that we did, except put a teleport pad somewhere over here. Not exactly where you teleport, or else you're just going to instantly or continuously just teleport back and forth. So put the spawn point a bit farther ahead or wherever you want, and then you can step on that one to go all the way back. If you don't really know what I'm talking about, I'll show you right now. We can go copy this and drag it over here, where we teleport, not where we actually teleport, so we don't go teleporting back and forth. I'm going to switch this one to a bit more of a light blue. And I'm actually going to rename this over here to teleport 2. And I'm going to get the position of this, which is that. I'm going to move this slightly over so we don't teleport right onto it. And then inside of our teleport 2 attribute, I'm going to change our current position with that. And now if we play, you should see that we get teleported over there. All right, we get teleported over here. And we get teleported back. And there you go, you have some simple teleporters that work all the time. Thank you for watching this quick tutorial. Hopefully you found it helpful, and if you did, make sure to subscribe. Thanks for watching.